Hello everybody, I got another wonderful video out here for you guys. We are straight on the PTR for 10.2.7, and I'm going to show you a lot of the stuff we know is coming here in Mists of Pandaria Remix. Whenever you get started in the realm, whenever this will go live, it will show you this splash screen explaining some of the basics of what Remix Pandaria is. You will get the option to create a time runner on the realm that you're on. Right now I'm on the PTR realm, so we got this blank list here on the side. You'll create this character just like you do any character on live. You can choose any class, any race, whatever it is that you want, as long as it is an existing race class combo in your regular World of Warcraft. Went ahead and just threw this character together. You got a nice human paladin. As you can see, they start at level 10 and they're going to have this hourglass next to their name that will indicate that they are specifically a time running character. You'll see that we start out here on the Timeless Isle with a small intro quest. Once you reach the end of this quest line, you then are shown one of the opening cinematics for Mists of Pandaria. That way you are reminded where we are lore-wise. Once you complete that intro scenario, you are brought through the Mists of Pandaria cinematic at the beginning, showing you where we are lore-wise. The one with Varian finding out that the bow with his son is missing. And then you are brought straight in to Pandaria, straight into the Jade Forest and into the quest line proper. Shortly into your questing experience, you'll run into a cache of infinite treasure. When you open this, you'll be given some basic items, which will show you some of the core mechanics of this WoW remix. The first one is the Unraveling Sands. This is a new button that you get to essentially bring. In BFA, we had the that junk system, the scrap system that was in that. It gives you an item to show how to scrap things. You'll be able to scrap any gear you get through this system and turn it straight into bronze, which is the currency which you're going to be able to use to upgrade your items and collect cosmetics. The other key thing here is the gems. It gives you a basic gem that you can go ahead and slot into your items just like how you would a normal gem here, right? The key difference is that you get a new ability to extract a gem. So if I exit out and then use it on here, I've extracted that gem and it's still fine. So I'm going to turn in this quest here, and I will turn in this intro quest here, and it gives me two more of the same gem, which means I can then upgrade them. So it's now a tier 2 gem, which I can then just socket in to my chest piece here. And that's a key part of this, is going to be all these gems that you can socket into these items to help increase your power even further. The other part is going to be your cloak. As you can see, I have a +1 to strength, stamina, and mastery. That's because those are the three threads that I picked up in the intro scenario. Threads appear to be able to drop from just any mob that's killed throughout this experience. And once you collect these threads, they're just automatically weaved into the cloak, which lets you have more power. Now, an important thing to know about this is it is mentioned to be account-wide progress. As far as I can tell, it comes from this achievement here, which says infinite power 1, which would indicate that there are multiple tiers of it. But that I'm not for sure, as I haven't progressed that far on the PTR yet. But I do know you have to at least gather 40 threads on one cloak for future time running characters to begin with threads collected. I don't know if that will be up to 40 or just a straight whatever you have collected, your alts will have collected as well. Another important thing to bring up here is that from the beginning, you see I'm here at level 11, I just finished the basic quests. I have the ability to dragon ride just straight from the beginning of Pandaria while I'm leveling. And this alone feels amazing. Another key thing of this event I'm going to bring you to is going to be the Infinite Bazaar. It's going to be one in every zone. So you see here's the one in the wilds. Here's one in the Valley of the Four Winds. And then there's one here in Vale of Eternal Blossoms as well. One for Dread Wastes, Down Long Steps, Kunlai Summit. I don't see one of that for Isle of Thunder, but you know, at least for all the main zones, there's certainly one. Another thing is there's these orbs in the air that you see I just got bronze for. They're just like the ones with the Dream Surges and Dragon Isles, except they give you bronze instead of the Emerald Currency. You see here Eternus is chilling outside of this bazaar. We're here, there are tons of vendors. There's going to be ones for the different raid sets. They are 5,000 apiece, 5,000 bronze, and you get the full set. Now note, you can collect this set on any class. So even though the appearance is only usable by cloth, I can collect it on this paladin. And it's interesting that they've set these up different from how some of the other sets are on life. And more along the lines of the War Within. Here we see all the different mounts. The first few pages are many of these beautiful recolors that we have seen being added to the event as brand new mounts. And then here on these last pages are a lot of these rare spawn ones. The costs are increased significantly on these. But these are guaranteed ways to get a lot of these rare drop mounts. Think of it as a sort of bad luck protection. Because you can still be trying these instances live on WoW for the ones that are obtainable on Modern. And then also in this remix to obtain these mounts. But if you're collecting bronze anyways, you can go ahead and try and buy these as well. Another important part is the item upgrade system. I don't have all the information yet, but as far as I can tell, all the gear is going to be upgradable to item level 556, which you can see here. There's 36 levels here. Now, these do have player level requirements, so I don't have enough bronze to really show it off, but you do have to hit, like, you know, certain levels like level 22, 23, so on and so forth to be able to upgrade your gear to those metrics. You can't just grind bronze without leveling to take power up yourself. Another important vendor here is this class apparel vendor. These are selling recolors of the trading post sets that were available earlier this year and the end of last year. Here we see a recolor of the paladin one and the weapon set as well. And it looks like these weapon sets do actually match the ones that we've already, the armor sets that we got in the trading post, where these are just full recolors. We have not seen these before in terms of the armor sets. And why this is read out is because you do have to get an achievement first on any class, but once you do have that, you can just buy these. So you see, if I use all, I can just use it, and again, it has that appearance is only usable by Death Knight. So I can still buy it on a paladin and use it on my other characters. And remember that these do carry forward to your modern account. Any of these appearances or mounts that you run here will carry forward to your modern account. Here we have a bunch of toys here. In particular note is the mini mana bomb, which is no longer obtainable as of live, but here, through this remix event, you're going to be able to obtain that again. We also have the dungeon apparel sets. These are 2,500 a piece and look amazing. I'm not sure if any of these are brand new recolors, as I'm not as familiar with the dungeon sets. You guys be sure to let me know if you find out they are. Guard yourself. One very important part is that there is this gym procurement vendor. What's notable is that the on-use effect for these is obtain a Tinker Gem you do not possess. So this isn't pure RNG, and for the abilities that you can eventually get them all. There's obviously some RNG elements, and you might get some sooner than others, but it is possible to get them all. You won't get duplicates, at least through this vendor. Here we have the heroic and mythic appearances for every single raid again. Looking wonderful. And then this is one of the vendors I was more excited about, is that there's these world appearances, including these shaman vestments, which two of these recolors are new to the game as far as I am aware. And these look beautiful. 2,500 apiece, 1,250 for some of the simpler transmogs, 750 for even some of the more simple ones. Alright guys, essentially that's everything that I know that's coming here in WoW Remix, Mists of Pandaria. If you guys have any further questions, please feel free to let me know. Essentially, this event is a weird season of discovery type thing where we have some new cool power that we're going to be able to grind up, some new achievements that are going to lead into all this, new mounts, collections, all that they're going to carry forward to your modern account. All your characters will be leveled 10 to 70, and once the event is over, they'll be moved over to your modern account. You'll be playing these raids to level up, because even some of the earlier ones unlock at level 30. And I'm very excited for this event. I think that this is going to be really good. WoW has been doing so good lately. And while I have been disappointed in some of the stuff, particularly Season 4, this is the sort of stuff that gives me hope again. Because this WoW remix looks amazing. And while we don't have an announced date on this yet, hopefully we get it sometime in mid to late May. And that would be amazing to be able to play through this, level up your characters to get ready for the War Within. For anyone who just wants to enjoy this wacky experience as well, don't feel like you're pressured to do a bunch of alt grinding, right? As I showed you, all these collections, you can buy them on one character. You don't have to level up one of each armor class. And that is amazing. So just keep on pulling out these wins, Blizzard. For everyone else who's watching this video, thank you for making it to the end. I do appreciate you so much. If there's anything else that you guys are wondering to know about WoW, please let me know down in the comments below. Feel free to subscribe and like this video as well if you enjoyed it. I'll see you all next time. You have a wonderful rest of your day.